welcome to Spectacular Hong Kong and Rugby Canada in Hong Kong. Hi everyone, I'm Keith Wells outside of Hong Kong Stadium, where the most prestigious event on the International Rugby Board's seven-a-side season is about to take place, the Hong Kong Sevens Tournament. 24 teams from around the world are here, including Canada. Over the next half hour, we're going to get a chance to learn a little more about these Canadian players representing our country at this tournament. We'll also learn a little more about the seven-a-side game, which most Canadians don't know a great deal about. Canadian players arrived here in Hong Kong a few days ago. Many of them wide-eyed getting off the bus and checking out the spectacular skyline here in Hong Kong. Many of them having never been to the city before. It's an amazing thing for these players. This is how, in fact, most of them spend their time back in Canada playing rugby on the weekends, in front of sparse crowds in Vancouver and Victoria in the BC Rugby Union. That's the situation one week, and then on the next week, here they are in front of thousands of fans in Hong Kong. We have lots of great rugby action to show you over the next half hour. We hope you can join us, and we'll start things off with the Canadians hitting the ground running. As soon as they arrived in Hong Kong, it was off to the pitch for their very first practice. After a full day of travel, it feels good to stretch out the limbs. That's what the National Sevens are doing at this Kowloon Park. Some of the spectators are more interested than others in the Canadians, led by Captain Marco Di Girolamo from Toronto. This year he's spreading himself between the Sevens, the National 15s, and his home club, the James Bay Athletic Association in Victoria. For Di Girolamo, this year has been like the construction site beside the pitch, a constant pounding. It's distracting for the players. They know their focus has to sharpen with the first game of the Hong Kong tournament.
This is the change. When you come on, you don't just come on. It's not like 15s where you get 5 minutes to warm up. You got to be dialed in so that when you come on the field, you're making an impact.
Maybe the players are still a little distracted. For that reason, the captain calls his own meeting of the players.
He just got the direction from the captain, and he has taken total control of this team, which is a great sign.
You've lost
happy.
Control, though.
I have lost control, and I'm glad to hand it over to that guy. he's stepping forward and taking charge and giving very good direction to the players. And it's good to see, and I think it's just a great step forward this year for him. And hopefully it'll build up for him when he goes into the World Cup for the 15s.
Can you do something about that, please?
Well, that noise over there, that's constantly happening. It's like a pounding headache after a big victory in Hong Kong.
It's a little more responsibility being the captain and stuff, but this is a great group of guys to be playing with, and we seem to be really gelling as a team. You know, we got a few new guys, but things are really coming together, and I'm expecting big things out of this tournament. This is one of the most exciting years of my life, you know, all the sevens and being captain and getting ready to go to the World Cup in Australia in October. It's every rugby player's dream.
Bigger rugby unions wouldn't have tolerated a din like this at one of their precious practices, but for the Canadian rugby team, it comes with the territory.
Oh, we're used to coming up as the underdogs and facing lots of adversity, and this is just another stepping stone for us.
Water, and then we'll go stretch around. Canada on three. One, two, three.
Canada!
Good work, guys. Good work, guys.
And here's a look at the starting lineup for Canada at the Hong Kong Sevens. The captain along with his club team, James Bay. Veteran Shane Thompson from Montreal. Todd McBride from White Rock. Quinton Fife, Calgary, also with James Bay. Chris Pack from Langley, BC. Eight players are new to the team, new to the Sevens circuit, including Matt King and David Moonlight, both with Victoria's Pacific Pride. Sterling Richmond making his debut here. Jesse Frender from Victoria, one of the veterans. Jake Osborne from Cumberland on Vancouver Island, Christoph Struben from Capilano Rugby Football Club, and Derek Daypuck from the Castaway Wanderers in Oak Bay, Spencer Robinson as a manager, and assistant coach to Edmonton's Rick Suggett. 24 teams at the tournament, six pools of four. Canada getting ready to play Japan in their Friday night opener. Players getting their very first look at the fans will be crammed into the south stands all weekend long.
It's crazy. It's a great atmosphere. Looking forward to getting the game underway and showing these fans some stuff about Canadian rugby.
Pretty incredible, actually. It's a brand new feeling I've never really felt before, stamping out for your country and having a go and trying to make it look like the world's best. It's a real thrill, and I'm proud to be here.
As mentioned, this is the first trip to the Hong Kong Sevens for eight of the Canadian players. It's hard not to be distracted. They're also dealing with nerves.
Yes, definitely some of the nerves, but also some of the pride in the history that's gone on here. Canada's had some of its best performances. Some of its, top cap earners and greatest players have started their careers here. You know, these guys are now buying into that tradition, So the red jersey, you can tell already, means quite a bit to them.
I think they're pretty well prepared for this one. Again, a very young group, but they're very enthusiastic. And Marco and Shane and Quinton have done a good job, you know, just quietly leading the team and getting them prepared for tonight. And it's been a great feeling. So hopefully we get some energy off this south stand over here and see how it goes from there.
Canada against Japan to open the tournament. And a look at the starting lineup for Canada. If you're not familiar with sevens rugby, the games are made up of 2 7-minute halves. Straight time, one game coming right after another. Feast of constant action for the rugby fan. And just like that, Canada will get the first try of this ball game. David Moonlight on the far side with his 9th try of the IRB season. It's unconverted, Canada with a 5-0 lead. But Japan comes right back. Yoshihiko Kukahama hanging onto the ball and racing the distance. 5-5 the score at halftime. Second half, and now the Canadian captain takes control of this game. Marco DiGirolamo with a kick and chase. He scrambles over the goal line, and it's 10-5. 24-12 is the final score for Canada. Not an impressive start, but it's a win, and they're now at 1-0.
It's a hard work. Every game's going to be like that, because that's what we're designed. That's the way we're built. Every game's going to be hard work, and we'll keep digging it up. We get the tries, we get the kicks, we make it happen. You came in, you made an impact. You came in, you made an impact. And then you tied it. It's a full team effort. Keep building on with this. Go, Marco, come on.
Game one is in the books. Time for Canada to take a break and get ready for their next 5 games to come. Time for us to take a break high above Hong Kong on the famous Peak Tram. We're back with more Rugby Canada in Hong Kong after this.
Oh, it's just spectacular.
It is spectacular. We came in. Yeah.
We came in on the ship, and this just seems to go on forever around the corner there. And you just think it's never going to end. Like I say, we've only seen a little bit of it, but yeah, spectacular is definitely the word.
If you happen to see the Canadian rugby team around, you're going to what?
Oh, we're going to watch them.
Well,
for sure.
We'll watch for them.
Give them a cheer.
Sure.
Absolutely. Rah-rah.
Absolutely.
One of the many markets here in Hong Kong. Looks like someone may have dropped an apple there, but that's all right. We're back here at Hong Kong Stadium, and as we saw, Canada with an opening win against Japan last night. We're at day number 2 of the Hong Kong tournament. 2 more games today with Canada taking on Fiji and Russia.
They're not totally disciplined, so our key will be to stay focused and stay disciplined, not take stupid penalties, and just try to run them off the park today.
And that is exactly how Canada opens a game against Russia. Terrific run by Quinton Fife from Calgary, finding his way through the Russians for his 6th try of the season. Canada with the convert, and it's 7-0. Russia having trouble in their own end now. Shane Thompson, the team veteran, pouncing on the ball to make it 14-0. And then rookie Derek Daypuk does a nice job holding things up for Fife later in the half. He's on his way once again. Great start to the game for Canada. They lead things 21-0 at halftime. But in sevens rugby, things can change very quickly. Canada falls on their heels in the second half, allowing Russia to score 3 tries. Unluckily for Canada, 1 conversion was missed. Canada wins 21-19. Another win, but it doesn't sit well with the head coach.
4 times to go for this game. Canada tennis.
That's the halftime, that's injury time, that's game time.
Guess we thought we had it in the bag, fell asleep in the second half. And that's the way the game of sevens goes. A couple of quick moves and boom, we're down. You know, 21-19. We got lucky there that he missed the conversion and we were able to finish the game on top.
2-0, but the Fiji will be a different thing altogether.
Yeah, you know, we've had a couple of close ones with Fiji, so hopefully we'll get our stuff together this afternoon, come out strong and put in a good performance.
The 7-a-side brand of rugby is, of course, a lot different from the 15-a-side rugby most people are accustomed to. But within Canada, the 7s and the 15s work very closely together. In fact, here's a head coach of the national 15-a-side team, David Clark, with his thoughts on the 7s game.
Well, there's no doubt that these guys, players going to Hong Kong to play in the sevens over there is the showcase of seven-a-side rugby in the circuit. That they can hone their skills. We'll be looking at them to see how they operate in space. They have good spatial awareness. It improves their skills, improves their one-on-one tackling. And so they do some very good things in that game. Now we've got Marco Di Girolamo, who's our captain. He's really setting the seven-a-side game alight. And he looks like he'll do very, very well in our 15s this year in the lead up to the World Cup.
There again is a Canadian captain in the white, getting ready for what should be a tough encounter with Fiji. Fiji comes into this tournament as one of the favorites, tied with Canada in the pool, but only the top finisher will move on to the cup finals along with two wild cards. Everyone else will have to battle it out for the plate championship or cup.
We win this game, we win our pool, and that should be our goal, and it has been our goal all week in our build-up, and Fiji's been our prime target. Maybe in the game previous against Russia, maybe we're looking too far ahead at the halftime, and so maybe they're refocused now.
Canada and Fiji, game number three of the tournament. Derek Daypuck from the Castaway Wanderers of the BCRU kicking it off. And a strong start for Fiji as Sakaraya Tui takes the ball up the middle, and after a give and go will score his first sevens try. Tui, a former national team member on the Fiji 15s, 7-0 the score. Canada counters on their next possession. Todd McBride getting the ball to Shane Thompson. The game is tied at 7 thanks to the hard-working veteran. You can hardly believe that he's now the veteran on the team and one of the longest-serving players in the entire league.
I'm 29. I've been on the team for about 5 years, I guess. But, I mean, the guys get on my back because I'm a little older than some of them, and I've been playing for a while, but I take it all in fun. It's good.
Shane Thompson.
He's now second in line behind Eric Rush, the great Eric Rush from New Zealand, in terms of seniority on the seventh circuit. And it shows out there, you know, 99% of the time he's doing the right thing. He's all about, you know, the full package, which is switch on when it's time to go on the field, but switch off and enjoy your experience while you're here or wherever you are and represent your country well.
The Montreal native says he's been lucky. He's had no major injuries. And if that keeps up, he could be wearing the red jersey for some time to come.
I just haven't had, knock on wood, I haven't had any trouble yet. I mean, major trouble that I had missed some games or tournaments, but I made a commitment a couple years ago that this is what I wanted to do, and I've stuck with it, and hopefully I'll see it through for another year or two.
Thompson hasn't had any major injuries, but that's not to say he doesn't take the odd hard knock.
Just took a good whack on the head and got a bit of a stinger, but he'll be all right by this afternoon, I think. It's the way it goes. Sometimes you get hit, sometimes you put in the hit.
No broken bones. But on this trip, the players say Thompson is nursing a broken heart.
So, again, this is Shane's song. He's had a little trouble lately.
Yeah. Teammate Chris Pack helping him through Broken Heartsville.
All I can say is bartender, pour me something strong.
Sing it with me, Shane.
Here's to the past, she can kiss my glass. I hope she's happy with him. Here's to the girl that wrecked my world. That angel did me in.
Here's the blue shell part, you know.
I think the devil drives the blue shell. I watched him drive away over the hill. Not against her will. I've got time to kill down in Broken Heartsville.
Thank you very much. We'll be here all week.
The players having some fun with the former captain of the Canadian team. Back at Hong Kong Stadium, halftime of the Canada-Fiji game, Fiji ahead 14-7. Surprising number of expatriate Canadians cheering in the stands. The team will need that help in 13 previous seven-a-side games. Fiji with a 13-0 record against Canada. Canada's defense, not much to look at in the second half of this game. Fiji will add a try at the very start of the second half. They add that try, and then another, and then one more. Fiji shows why they're one of the top teams on the IRB circuit with a 33-12 victory. They win the pool, but Canada still may have a mathematical chance.
Put a whack of points on us. Maybe our 12 points in this game might get us through into the cup round, okay?
Coaches head upstairs to do the math, but it doesn't look like Canada will have the numbers to get into the cup round.
I think we missed out by 11 points. We were left too many points in against Fiji. It's a tough sell.
So we end up negative 11 on the points, so we're in the plate round. So now what we got to do is pick ourselves back up and win the plate. Okay, let's put some points onto it. So we know where we're at, now let's strive for that challenge right there. Okay, let's go.
We'll move on to the plate round of the Hong Kong Sevens after a quick break and a trip across the Hong Kong Harbour on one of the famous Star Ferries. Rugby Canada in Hong Kong, brought to you by Speedway Motors, will continue after this.
Firstly, I would like to introduce you our masters. And this is Pandora, and this Thomas, and I'm William. We're very happy to meet you this morning. And now I would like to give you a brief on what Tai Chi is. Tai Chi is a physical exercise beneficial both to our body and mind. Tai Chi was created by watching and imitating the gesture of animals fighting and based on the theory of the cosmos. So Tai Chi is a philosophy.
After some morning stretching, everyone is ready for the final day of action here at the Hong Kong Sevens Rugby Tournament. Hong Kong Stadium sitting in behind me here, where the Canadians are getting ready for their fourth game of the event. Here's a look at the Cenotaph in Hong Kong. And you know, Canadians are warmly remembered here for their efforts in helping fight to defend Hong Kong during the Second World War. A little perspective on that now from 96-year-old Hilda Hale of Victoria, who arrived in Hong Kong and lived here for a number of years immediately after the Second World War.
When I entered Hong Kong with my family in 1946, it was a very devastated place. And accommodation was very hard to find because it was still under military control. Canadian soldiers and nurses were some of the first of the military to arrive in Hong Kong when the Japanese struck, and they suffered devastating results. To think of our lovely young men suffering so and dying for the sake of this British colony makes me very proud.
The underdog Canadians are usually one of the fan favorites at this event. Not when they play Hong Kong. Canadian team needs a win to keep moving on. Last time they won any championship at this event, by the way, was 1995 when they won the plate. And it will take three more wins to do it this time. Canada squandered a couple of good chances early in the game against Hong Kong. Then they make good on the first try of the game. Jesse Frender from Victoria racing in to score here. He was Canada's top scorer a couple of years ago until he was sidelined with a leg injury. He's certainly better now. Canada with the lead. 12-0 later, Quinton Fife with the great skills getting the kick into touch for Frender with the score again. Five more points for Canada. Final play of the match. Chris Pack scoring to make it 24-0. And with a 3-1 record, Canada moves one step closer to the plate.
Let's go. Two more to go. Good job, eh? Good job. Two more to go.
Canada against Korea in the plate semifinal. Canadian team starting to get things rolling. Maybe it's because Captain Marco Di Girolamo is winding it up. A hard-fought try. 7-5 Canada. Di Girolamo again to speedster David Moonlight. In the end, 33-10 Canada. Lots of fun for the Canadian players when the games are going along like this.
That's what we come for, eh?
Yeah.
It's good time.
And the girls, but Tiff, not me, everyone else. Not me, honey.
Excellent stuff. You're really coming together. Marco, let's have a nice good cool down. Let's get ourselves prepared for the plate final. Let's knock off the professionals. Let's knock off the professionals now. Let's show them what good old Canadian character is made out of. That's a fantastic game. Way to go, Carlos.
So it's Scotland against Canada for the plate championship, and a bit of motivation for the Canadians taking on the full-time paid professionals.
Let's go Canada! Woo!
Fans are excited. Scotland also anxious for the win, coming off a loss to Canada at the Commonwealth Games. 15-a-side team from Scotland also fell to Canada last fall in Vancouver. David Moonlight getting things going for Canada with a thundering hit on Scotland's Mark Lee. Bit of old-time hockey as he keeps him out of touch. Then later, Moonlight will help get the ball to Todd McBride, who will score the first try of the ball game. McBride finds some room, and with his tank apparently right on empty, takes it over for a 7-0 lead.
Yes, Todd! Oh, that's fantastic. Hey, keep that up. Let's go. Keep that up.
A promising start to the game for Canada and an exciting way to end the first half. Marco Di Girolamo breaking free for the second try of the ball game.
And the scoring machine for Canada, Marco Di Girolamo.
PA announcer with a nickname Di Girolamo will be hearing from his teammates for a while. The scoring machine, making it 14-0 at the break. One more strong half and the plate will belong to Canada.
Pride and courage in that first 5 minutes, and you sacrificing your boys in those tackles have given you the 14-0 lead. Nothing stops you now. The back page of our book says believe. You believe in it because you're going it. Look to ice. Keep driving it. Keep driving it. Great leader. Let's take these guys home.
Great atmosphere at halftime of the event, and it's something the Canadians could soon experience with Edmonton being mentioned as a possible stop on the IRB circuit next season.
This is a great event right here, and we hope to next year have this happen in Commonwealth Stadium in Edmonton, and the IRB has taken a serious look at the proposal put together by Rugby Canada, and if we can match some of this next spring, we're going to be a happy union.
First things first, though, Canada with one more half to play against Scotland. Jesse Frender with another big try. And with the conversion, Canada has a 19-0 lead.
Has he got it? Has he got it? It's a beauty.
But it's not over yet. Scotland will finally get on the board a few minutes later. Sean Lamont finds an opening, takes it across to make it 19-7. Then a wild chase for the ball in the end zone. Ian McEnroy getting past Di Girolamo. Suddenly it's 19-14 with only a few minutes left to play. Scotland needs one more chance to put together a drive. But can they do it? Will they have time? The answer is no. Canada wins the Hong Kong plate.
Scenes of joy and jubilation then. Canada have done it under their new captain, Marco Di Girolamo.
I told you we were going to win it.
Oh my God, this is awesome. I didn't think anything could get better than winning the bowl in Wellington, and then bowl, plate, cup. I think it has a nice ring to it.
First experience of sevens, and couldn't ask for anything better than this. Big victory in the plate final. Happy as hell, happy as hell.
A sweet victory over the professionals from Scotland. All the more surprising with 8 rookies in the lineup, a bow for the fans in the south stands. And what a difference from the scene at home after a big win. Chris Pack putting an exclamation point on that, throwing his rugby shorts into the wild Hong Kong crowd. And that is it. A nice ending to the Hong Kong Sevens for the National Sevens team. Now it's back home to the relative anonymity of rugby life in Canada and in British Columbia. As the head coach mentioned, you never know, these same Canadians could have a chance to win another championship on home turf at some point in the near future. From Hong Kong, I'm Keith Wells. So long. Rugby Canada in Hong Kong has been brought to you by Speedway Motors in Victoria, Canada's oldest Volkswagen dealership. Cathay Pacific Airlines, the national carrier of Hong Kong, serving destinations across the Far East. And the Marco Polo Hong Kong Hotel, where the players stay while attending the Hong Kong Sevens.